Mrs. Wong her condolence and give her support in facing the future with strength and encouragement. I first met Mr. Wong back in 1969 when he came to Canada. He was 33 and I was 22. Somehow through some acquaintances, we got together and we struck up a very good friendship. He had amazing qualities. He was good with people and he had skills. And he was very much into martial arts, especially Wing Chun. At that time, Bruce Lee was the craze. Chinese Kung Fu in Wing Chun was widespread. Together, I think we had a very good time in establishing a martial arts school in Wing Chun in the basement of his father-in-law's house. I think at that time, we must have had over 100 or 200 students come through the school. And there were many, many, many people. There were doctors, lawyers, pharmacists, postal workers, restaurant workers, you name it. They all came and they all enjoyed the participation there. Like we were like a big family. And even today, we have several students from the original days, they're here. And one of our students, Mr. Danny Shun here, he has become a sifu himself and continued teaching. And even wrote a book about it. Those were the good times, and after reviewing the slideshow, I think Mr. Wong had a glorious life, many achievements, and he should be very proud. We should be very proud of him. He had many, many, many interests in life. He liked gardening. He grew his vegetables in the backyard. He liked fishing. Oftentimes we go out fishing with him and they come back with a lot of catches and we have wonderful dinners in his basement. Oh yes. He was a very remarkable man. He also has some other skills that many of you don't know. He was taught in the art, Chinese art of pedicure and jiaxu, which is like massage. And back then in the early 20s, I was just finishing my dental school and practicing. And I met a friend, Mr. James Allen, and he was a examiner on the board of the Ontario College of Masseurs. And I said, well, you should put that into work. And I talked to Mr. Allen, and he said, well, I have an amazing gentleman here who wants to continue his practice of massage in Canada, but he doesn't have English. He said, never mind, bring him along, let me try him out. So I made an appointment, I took him to his house. And when we got there, we filled out some forms, and I did it actually, he doesn't know English. And then he took him to his back room and tried out his massage techniques. It was amazing. I don't know how he did it, but he impressed his examiner so well that he says, okay, Mr. Wong, you pass. And from that point on, he was able to work in Ontario as a licensed masseur. I think that was really remarkable for a man of his stature. So, in memory of Mr. Wong, we should not grieve. We should celebrate. The man has achieved quite a lot. And oftentimes, in his basement, we enjoy a family of students. And even today, I have several of them that I keep in touch with. And we all grow and pass on. But he, I'm sure, will remember all of us. And to sum it all up, I think he had a motto that was written on the wall. In Chinese it says, Yat yat bat yin, sam yat sao. 三日不言言錯過. It translates directly to the fact that you should practice whatever you do to be successful, whatever. You must practice. I think that's the philosophy that we should all carry with us. Continue to practice and believe in yourself, and you'll be successful. Thank you. At this point, I would like to